Good morning, student. In today's video, I am going to start new lesson of maths. Six lesson, and the name of the lesson is square and square root. Here I take some question from exercise 6.1. Okay, question number 1 is given. Write the next two numbers in the following pattern. One pattern it is given, pattern of the numbers, that is 1, 4, 9, 16, and 25. If you observe these numbers, we understand these are the perfect square number. 1 is the square of 1, 4 is the square of 2, 9 is the square of 3, 16 is the square of 4, 25 is the square of 5. Therefore, next number is the square of 6 and 7. Next two numbers, okay? And therefore, next two numbers are 6 square, that is 36, and after that 6, 7, and its square is what? 49. This is the answer for the first question. Okay. Then see the second question. Question number second is given. Which of the following numbers are perfect square? Some numbers are given here. You have to identify the given number is perfect square number or not. Okay, for that you have to find out the prime factor for the given number. Okay, now here I take the A example from the question number second. Number is given 81. We have to identify 81 is perfect square number or not. Okay, for that we find out the prime factor. Now 81 is divisible by which prime number? It is not divisible by 2, it is divisible by 3. Correct. Therefore, here I write 3, 81 divided by 3. Here we get what? 27. Then 27 is divided by again 3. Here we get the 9. Okay. We know that 9 is also divisible by 3. Then here I write 3, 3s are 9. Okay. Then here we get the 3. Again 3 is divisible by 3. Then 4. 3 divided by 3, here we get the 1. Okay. Now see which are the prime factor for the 81? That is 3, 3, 3 and 3. Correct. These are the prime factor of 81. Now you can write like that. 81 is equal to 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay. Now see, in this prime factor, prime factors are in pair. Now first pair is there, again pair of this three number. Okay. If the prime factors of the given numbers are in pair, then that number is perfect square number. So we can say 81 is perfect square. Understood? Now see the next example from question number second. Here I take the F example. Number is given 570. Okay. Now to identify this number is perfect square or not, we find out the prime factor. Now to 570 it is given, it is divisible by 2. Okay, 570 divided by 2, 2 2s are 4, here we get 1. Okay, then 7, 2 8s are 16, 1 then 0, 2 5s are 10. Here we get what? 285. Okay. Now 285 is not divisible by 2. Then think about the next prime number. Next prime number is what? 3. Now see this number is divisible by 3 or not. We can use the divisibility property of the 3. If sum of the digit in the given numbers is divisible by 3, then that number is divisible by 3. Okay. Now 2 plus 8 plus 5, this is equal to 15. Their addition is what? 15. 15 is divisible by 3, therefore whole number is divisible by 3. Therefore here I take the next prime number or the factor, that is 3. If you divide 285 by the 3, then we get a division 95. Okay. Then since 95 is not divisible by 3, then we can think about the next prime number. 95 is divisible by what? 5. Therefore 95 divided by 5, here we get 90. Okay, 19 is the prime number, it is divisible by 19 only, therefore next factor here I take 19. 19 ones are 19. Now 2, 3, 5 and 19 are the factors of 570. Okay, so we can write 570 as 2 into 3 into 5 into 19. Okay, now see, these are the prime factor of number 570 which are not in pair. Which are not in pair, therefore given number is not perfect square number. Okay student, I hope you understand how to identify given number is perfect square number or not by taking their prime factors. Okay, now see the next question. Here I explain question number third. Find the square of following number. It is very easy. Some numbers are given here. Here I take A example. We have to find out its square. Okay. Therefore, square of 8. We represent like that. 8 square. 8 raised to the power 2. Represent the what? 8 square. To find out the square of 8 is equal to, we have to multiply this number how many times? 2 times. That is 8 into 8. 64. Represent the square of 8. Is it? 8 into 8 what? 64. Then, see next number here, I take the example 35. Okay, find out the square of 35. We write 35 square is equal to, we have to multiply 35 here 2 times 35 into 35. And their multiplication is what? 1225. You can do the rough work here, okay, and find out the correct product or the multiplication. Here we get 1225 is the square of 35. Okay, I hope student you understand all these questions. Question number one pattern it is given, from that we have to find out the next two number. We find all these numbers are the perfect square number, then we easily find out the next two perfect square number, that is 36 and 49. Question number second is given, identify which numbers are perfect square or not by using prime factors. Or here find a prime factor for the given number and we identify which number is perfect square and which number is not perfect square. And third question, it is very easy, we have to find out its square. By multiplying the number 2 times, you will get the square of that number. Okay. Now note down your homework from question number 2nd. Okay. Remaining example, which are the example now, A and F here I take. Then B, C, D and E. Okay. These are the homework for the from question number 2nd. And from question number 3rd, B and C. Okay. This is all for today, student. Thank you. Thank you very much.